Hey guys, it's Tom Box here, and I'm still kind of sick and don't really want to talk about this, but I will, and this is going to be regarding Konami's tournament policy regarding several rules, one being match slip reporting and the other being bribery and collusion. Why am I talking about this? Well, there is that whole situation with Billy Brick and Jackie Bertel right now. Both players, as of recording this video, they are still currently on the suspended list. And we got to get to the bottom of this, and I want everyone to kind of have a clear grasp of what's going on, and I want to give viewers a fair viewpoint of what's going on both sides. I want to hear both their story and what is currently being presented to, I guess, the audience right now. And I am misinformed about anything. Please leave it down in the comment section below. Guys, check the comment section and see if there's more updated information there. And with that, I'm going to, I guess, continue with this segment. Now, for those of you guys who don't know, they are currently getting suspended for the allegations of collusion. And if you guys don't know who Billy Brick is, Billy Brick is, I would say, like a hero to the community because he is one of the strongest player of this community. He would be the Yugi of America. If I would give him a title, he would be one of the King of Games. And yeah, he is a very impressive player. He's probably a role model to many of the players out there. A lot of people want to play like him. And as for Jackie is, well, one of the strongest female players in this community, if not the strongest. I would say she's probably the strongest, with a very, very successful run in the game as well. I believe they're also a couple, Billy and Jackie. Correct me if I'm wrong there. I just don't want to make any kind of mistakes there. And yeah, so both of them are actually, I believe, suspended for the same reason. Now, where did this all stem from? And before I actually get to this, I want to clarify a couple of Konami policies. Now, it is stated here in Konami's tournament document here, official KD tournament policy version 1.4, in page 11 under tournament rules, section B, reporting the match result. I'm just going to read this out here so you guys can kind of follow up with me. Players are responsible to accurately report the result of their match. The outcome of a match cannot be changed once the match has concluded, and the match result slip cannot be altered once it has been submitted. So, too bad, so sad. Once you've submitted the list in, it is over, even if you check the wrong box. Okay, so there's that. The outcome of a match cannot be changed. To give us an example right here, during game 3 of a match, player A deals enough damage to bring his opponent's life points to 0. So he deals enough damage to bring it to 0. So in other words, I believe this is when the damage has successfully been dealt. A match has officially ended with player A as the winner. Even though the match result slip has not been signed yet, player A is no longer allowed to concede to his opponent as the match already has an official result. Okay, fair enough. So I'm not allowed to concede the moment the winner is declared. Sounds simple enough, alright? Okay, nothing too complicated there. And there's actually a bit of a loophole that many players do abuse at this point. But overall, it's still fair game. I mean, anyone can choose to scoop to anyone. That's how the game goes. Now, C, Section C states, bribery and collusion. The outcome of a match may not be influenced by outside incentives or additional prizes / compensation. Offering or accepting a bribe is against tournament policy and will result in disqualification from the event. In addition, there's also Section D, which is a random outcome. You cannot roll for the win. Okay, well, what does this actually mean? Well, for the reporting match result part of this this policy, there seems to be a giant loophole regarding when you can do it. You can scoop whenever you want, just you cannot scoop during the end of a match. So from the moment you sit down at the table, all the way till before the final attack is dealt, or before the final damage is dealt to push you to 0, or before you top deck yourself to death, the other player can still concede. This is all still available. The other player can concede during the entire long time frame. Whether or not you just sat down, you signed the slip and called it a day, or maybe you wait till the very last attack and decide like, yeah, I'm just screwing with you, I'm gonna scoop because I gotta go anyway. That is still all technically very legal, even within the document itself. But once the damage is dealt, it is done. Once one person is declared the loser, whether or not the slip is signed, that result cannot change. And if it's changed, you're misreporting your result, and therefore it will result in some sort of punishment. But the thing is, Billy Brick and Jackie Bertel, they're not getting hit for reporting like the match result. I don't think they're getting hit by that. I think what they're getting hit by is collusion. At least that's the rumor that's going around. Collusion, the outcome of a match. Did they actually get hit or incentivized by outside prizing? Well, I'll let you guys be the judge of that, because we gotta, well, get to the bottom of this. And the procedure of this matters a lot. Okay, the procedure itself matters a lot, and I'll let you guys also, you know, find your own reasoning for this. Now, why is this happening to Billy and Jackie? And here's the thing, regarding the situation, in one of House of Champs videos, this is one of the deck profiles that Billy Break is offering, he states in the very first minute, and links down in the description below, please check it out for yourself, he states, I'm going to paraphrase here, during the final rounds, Jackie and Billy played against each other, Jackie beat him, and then Jackie feels sorry for him, and she didn't need the points anyway, so then she gave Billy the win. And all of it was said in a very humorous tone, perhaps. Maybe it was just dramatized to increase the humor factor, I don't know. And one thing to note about Billy is that he's aware that he is one of the strongest players in this game, and for him to admit defeat, he tried to spin it in a more humorous way of someone taking pity on him, that the best player is losing kind of deal. I feel like that's the spin he kind of took on, except that it kind of backfired. And a lot of you guys might be like, red flags, that's actually going against the policy already, because based on the past things that we stated about, you know, match result reporting, once the match is done, well, I guess you can't alter the results. And that's one thing that was pointed out. And the second thing to point out is, where's the collusion on this? What's there to gain? Well, I think that might be related to the points. Now, this is just one side of the story, okay, guys? And there's actually another side which will be coming from House of Champs. But regarding the points thing, it's actually kind of dumb if that is actually the issue, because the whole points thing is that if I want to scoop to someone and want to give them my points, that's up to me. I'm not offering them anything. I am losing to give them my points. But the whole procedure of this whole incident, I think, is where the problem is at. Now, the biggest difference between bribery and collusion, even though they're kind of under the same clause, is that bribery would be offering the incentive. Collusion is more like two players working together for a favorable result. It's more likely to happen in the case of where two players are both undefeated and it is the final round. To secure the maximum prizing available to both these players, they agree to a draw. Forcing a draw would be collusion, and both players would technically get DQ'd for it because they're forcing themselves to be both first and second. And then therefore all the prizing, if it's top heavy, well, just shoots up right to the top, therefore keeping both player standings in this exact same spot. That would be collusion. But here's a statement from House of Champs, Jonathan Moore. Now, Jonathan Moore states on Zodiac Duelist, he states that in the video he makes a joke that Jackie felt bad for him and scooped to give him the points. As soon as they sat down, they signed the match slip and marked the winner at the event. Altering a tournament result is a bannable offense, which we've already gone through previously, but they have already decided the winner. And then, after that, played for practice for the regional the following day, where in this game she beat them. Or she beat him, I guess. And they did not alter the tournament result. There was nothing given for scooping. Everything followed procedure. Billy will be appealing the ban. Now, if what Jonathan Moore says is true, there's technically no policy being broken. In fact, everything following procedure, and even regarding the points, shouldn't have affected any of this. The reason being is that the points are actually part of the tournament prizing, and there's no additional outside incentive going in. This is still prizes that Konami will be distributing out. This is not some sort of, hey, I got like 50,000 points, here you need some points. In addition to the points that you'll be winning, I'll give you some of my own. Like, that's not it. That's not the case here. He's just gonna get the points for the regular tournament, which I don't see. According, if I'm going to be reading Konami tournament policy, the matches may not be influenced by any outside incentives or additional prizes and compensation. There's nothing that's coming from the outside. Now, the whole situation actually boils down to whether if they did, you know, sign the match slip earlier before the match even started, or if they didn't. Seriously, just these two outcomes. Now, if they did sign the match slip early, then they didn't break any procedure. They obviously did things correctly, because players can choose to scoop whenever they want. Like, you can't control when someone is going to concede. I'm like, I concede to you. Well, are you going to question it? I was like, oh my god, my opponent surrendered to me. What is he up to? You're not going to think about that stuff. Especially when there's no outside prizes, you know, influencing their decision. I mean, are you guys still dating someone for conceding? Just because they're friends? I mean, that kind of goes against the whole logic of a trading card game, which is a community to build friendship. I mean, do you actually want to go prove their point? Do you want to prove what's their intent? I mean, what's the point of all this? I mean, if there's bribery involved, then yes, obviously investigate the crap out of that. But if this was the case where they already signed the matchup to begin with, then what is there to investigate? And, well, if they didn't, well, submit the match slip early, well, then that would actually imply that they did impede on the one clause, which would be the reporting of the match result. They would have misreported the match result. I'm not sure if collusion would actually apply, because if collusion did apply, then we would actually have a whole thing open for people asking for their Nats invite at the final round when they're bubbling out and their opponent has one and they don't have one. They're like, you just want to give me the invite? You know, by asking that question, it's kind of taboo already. Like, why are you putting yourself in that spot where someone can call a judge? What would the judge say? You know, I'm just going to leave it at that for you guys to interpret. But where do you guys stand when it comes to this situation? Do you think Billy and Jackie, you know what, they were just, it was just a joke, just let him go? Or do you think he should be responsible for things that he said on video? And with that being said, I personally hope both of you guys, you know, make a successful appeal against Konami. Maybe it was all a joke. Hopefully this whole thing gets blown over. You know, no one's going to talk about it. But that being said, what are some things that we did learn from this video? Well, first of all, be responsible about the things that you say in a video. I mean, you know, if things can come back and bite you in the ass, it's like Facebook. People that are dumb enough to admit to crimes on Facebook as a joke, not everyone's going to look at that the same way. Maybe the wrong people or the right power is going to look at it and might as well put you in a very awkward situation, a very serious situation, which could no longer be a joke to you anymore. And one thing that I learned about Konami is that they have a zero tolerance towards anyone in the community that would go against their policy. Regardless of how influential you are, regardless of how much you would help sales and promote the game, it doesn't matter. You go against them, it's like bam, you're suspended. And they will potentially use the stuff that you say on a video against you, so just be careful of that. And with that being said, if you guys have anything to add and you want to leave your thoughts down in the comments section below, please do. If you guys enjoyed this video, please leave a thumbs up if you guys want to see more stuff from MSD.TV. And man, my voice is... this is the most painful video I've done in a long time. I've actually done 30 cuts from just me cutting out the coughing. If you guys want to see a new video, check that link on the right over there. If you guys want to see more stuff from MSD.TV, please hit the subscribe button. And as always, don't forget to hold on to your MSD.TV.